More than 300,000 women worldwide die each year due to pregnancy-related complications and childbirth, mostly from preventable or treatable causes. Sadly, a big percentage of these deaths happen in developing countries like Uganda. In an effort to curb the increasing maternal and infant mortality rate, midwives and pediatricians have been trained in basic life support, systematic approach to illness recognition, practical airway and breathing, circulation and physical assessment skills, pediatric early warning system, and teamwork, as well as communication.
We have just had the most wonderful week of training here at Nurture Africa in Uganda. We spent the first 2 days of our week training, providing pediatric resuscitation course, a basic one on the first day, a more advanced course on the second day. Over the course of those 2 days, we identified really strong candidates who we invited back to do our first ever PERS Ugandan Train the Trainer course. We've spent the last 2 days working alongside the fabulous healthcare professionals of Uganda, from Nurture Africa Health Centre, from Kwempe, from Malago, from other health centres, 3 and 4 around the district.
The training has been organised by a PERS programme from Ireland with an aim of improving healthcare in Uganda. Talema Cranman, the clinical manager from Nature Africa, explains the criteria used to select hospitals and doctors that have benefited from this programme.
This PERS training is a training that has been ongoing for the last 3 years, which was interrupted by COVID-19. Previously, we were doing a selection from different health facilities in Nansana, Mulago, and also Kawempe National Referral Hospital for Women. But this year's program has been different from the previous programs that were held. This has been a program that was to select trainers of trainees. So the selection that we used was we worked with the different health facility in charges and also different hospital directors, like the director for Mulago, director for Kawempe, for the reproductive health program, so that we would have a mix of clinical officers, midwives, medical doctors.
Dr. Kamara Daniel, one of the beneficiaries of this training, noted that many doctors need this kind of training to help improve on their skills and cope with the new technology and trends.
This training has imparted more skills in me, and this training actually, it has been a 5-day training, and I'm now a trainer of trainees, so I can now train other more health workers regarding about PERS. Because every health worker has one time experienced an emergency, especially for children, and this is very important. And we've also looked into the PEWs, the pediatric early warning signs, how you can easily identify them, you act accordingly, and the intervention becomes purposeful, and you call for your senior help as urgent as you can.
The current maternal mortality ratio in Uganda is 336 maternal deaths per 100,000 live births. Infant mortality is 43 deaths per 1,000 live births, with 42% of the mortality occurring during the neonatal period. Report compiled by John Musenze for the news.